Hi everyone, I'm Priyanka and today we will discuss gas chromatography. Gas chromatography. It is the process of separating components from the given crude drug by using a gaseous mobile phase. It involves a sample being vaporized and injected on the head of the chromatographic column. The sample is transported through the column by the flow of inert gaseous mobile phase. The column itself contains a liquid stationary phase which is absorbed onto the surface of an inert solid. Two major types: gas solid chromatography. Here, the mobile phase is a gas, while the stationary phase in a solid. Used for separation of low molecular gases, for example, air components, hydrogen, sulfur, carbon dioxide, rare gases, carbon monoxide, and oxides of nitrogen. Next, we have gas liquid chromatography. The mobile phase is a gas, while the stationary phase is in liquid, retained on the surface as an inert solid by adsorption or a chemical bonding. Talking about the principle of separation in gas chromatography is partition. The mixture of the components to be separated is converted to vapors and mixed with gaseous mobile phase. The components which is more soluble in stationary phase travel slower and eluted later. The components which is less soluble in stationary phase travel faster and eluted out first. No two components have same partition coefficient condition. So the components are separated according to their partition coefficient. This partition coefficient is the ratio of solubility of a substance distributed between two immiscible liquids at a constant temperature. Talking about the instrumentation, first we have a carrier gas, commonly we use helium and argon. Next we have sample injected port, column, detector. Further, we have four type of different detector: thermal conductivity, TCD, electron capture detector, ECD, flame ionization detector, FID, then flame photometry, FPD. So here we have the complete setup of gas chromatography. Starting from the carrier gas supply, which is further connected to a gas flow controller. Now this gas flow controller is connected to a sample injector port. The one end of which is connected to the column in oven. The other end of the column is connected to a detector outside the oven. Now this detector is further connected to a data system where the different data acquisition, data processing and data storing are performed. Let us discuss the different parts. First, we have a carrier gas. The cylinder or the gas tank is fitted with a pressure controller to control the pressure of the gas. A pressure gauge that indicates the pressure, a molecular sieve to transfer filtered dry gas, and flow regulator to ensure a constant rate of flow of mobile phase to the column. It should meet the following criteria: should be chemically inert, should be cheap and readily available, should be of high quality and not cause any fire accidents, should give best possible results, should be suitable for the samples to be analyzed and for the detector. Hydrogen, helium, nitrogen and carbon dioxide are commonly used. Hydrogen have low density and better thermal conductivity. However, it reacts with unsaturated compounds and is inflammable, explosive in nature. Talking about the nitrogen is inexpensive, but it gives reduced sensitivity. Helium is the most preferred one. Inlet pressure ranges from 10 to 15 psi. Flow rate is about 25 to 150 ml per minute for packed column. Flow rate around 2 to 25 ml per minute for open tubular column. Next we have sampling unit. Now the sampling unit or injector port is attached to the column head. Since the sample should be in vaporized state, the injector port is provided with an oven that helps to maintain its temperature at about 20 to 50 degrees above the boiling point of the sample. Gaseous samples may be introduced by the use of a gas tight hypodermic needle of 0.5 to 10 ml capacity. For liquid sample, micro syringes of 0.1 to 100 microliter capacity may be used. Injection of sample into the capillary column. Split injections. It split the volume of the sample stream into two unequal flow by means of the needle valve and allow the small flow to pass on to the column and the bigger part is allowed to vent to the atmosphere. This technique is not suitable when the highest sensitivity is required. Next we have stripless injectors. They allow the samples to pass through the column for loading. The sample should be very dilute to avoid overloading of the column and the high capacity of the column, such as SOT, SCOT or heavily coated WCOT column should be used. On column injectors, a syringe with a very fine quartz needle is used, air-cooled to minus 20 degrees Celsius below the boiling point of sample. After then, the warmer air is circulated to vaporize the sample. Next, we have automatic injectors. For improving the reproductivity and if the large number of samples are to be analyzed or operation is required without any attendant, automatic injectors are used. The solid sample are introduced as a solution or in a sealed glass crushed in the gas steam with the help of a gas tight plumber, and the sample get vaporized and flow into the column under the influence of the carrier gas. Next we have column unit. Column are of different shape and size that includes U-tube type or a coiled helix type. They are mainly made up of copper, stainless steel, aluminium, glass, nylon or other synthetic plastic. Support material. Its main function is to provide mechanical support to liquid phase. An ideal support should have a large surface area, chemically inert, should get uniformly wet with liquid phase and should be thermostable. Commonly used solid phases are like glass beads, porous polymer, sands, etc. Liquid phase. It should have the following requirements. It should be non-volatile, should have high decomposition temperature, should be chemically inert, should possess low vapor pressure at column temperature, should be chemically and structurally similar to that of solutes, that is polar for a polar solute. Next we have type of column. There are two general type of columns, packed columns. In gas liquid chromatography, they are densely packed with finely divided inert solid support materials, coated with liquid stationary phase. Here the support material is the dichromaceous earth. Okay, in gas solid chromatography, the columns are packed with the absorbent or porous polymers. Okay, this is the difference between them. The length is around 1.5 to 10 meters. Internal diameter is around 2 to 4 mm. In capillary columns, the length range from 10 to 100 meters. Inner diameter is around 0.1 to 0.5 mm. It is further of mainly of two types. Wet coated columns consist of a capillary tube whose walls are coated with liquid stationary phase. Next we have support coated columns, where the inner wall of the capillary is lined with a thin layer of support materials such as dichromaceous earth, onto which the stationary phase has been absorbed. It is also known as porous layer open tubular column. Quad columns are generally less efficient than what quad columns. Both type of capillary columns are more efficient than packed columns. So here you can see porous layers open tubular columns with thin layer with particle layer thickness of around 0.15 micrometer. Next we have packed columns. Then next we have wall coated open tubular columns. Equilibrium of column. The packed column are equilibrated before introduction of sample. This is done by allowing continuous flow of heated carrier gas through the column for a specific duration of time, around 24 hours. Ideal preparated and conditioned column shows a zero baseline on the recorded upon passing of gas, carrier gas alone. Talking about the column temperature, this can be controlled by the jacket equipped with vapors of boiling liquid, electrically heated metal blocks, or circulating air bath. Compounds of low boiling point eluted at low temperature, compounds of high boiling point boiled at higher temperature, resulting in borders and shadowing peaks, required temperature programming. Next we have detectors. The eluted solute particles along with the carrier gas exit the column and enter the detector. The detector then produces electrical signal proportional to the concentration of the components of the solute. The signals are amplified and recorded as a peak at interval on the chromatogram. Properties of an ideal detector: sensitive, operate at temperature around 0 to 400 degrees Celsius, stable and reproductive, linear response, wild, dynamic range, fast response, simple, reliable, non-destructive, uniform response to all analytes. That's all we have in the first part. Thank you and have a nice day.